In this video, we are going to see the characteristics of SCR, otherwise called a thyristor. So for that, we need, as per the standard diagram, we need the DC source. We will take the DC power source. Then we will take one more source called from the signal voltage source block. We will take a DC interactive voltage source. So this is nothing but a variable voltage source. Then we will take the resistance of 1 kilo ohm resistor, that we will place it here, and we will take another resistor of 1 kilo ohm. Okay, next we will take the important device called the SCR. Here I will choose the SCR, that is 2N2573 as the SCR. To study the characteristics of this SCR, we are taking, right? Now we will take to measure the voltage and current, we will take the multimeter from the right side palette. Let us copy this one. I will take I need a 2 ammeter and 1 voltmeter, right? Second, third one, we place it here. Now and also we will take the we will take the right. Now as per the standard diagram, we also need the ground for the circuit. We will take the ground terminal and place it here. Now as per the standard diagram, you connect with the wires. Let us connect the wires. Right, now the connection is made. Now we will check this as ammeter with the DC ammeter value. And the second multimeter is set as the ammeter, and the third multimeter is set as the voltmeter to measure the voltage, that is a DC voltmeter. So we will place all the multimeter to be visible. Double click and paste as a visible one. Now the circuit is ready. Let us run the circuit. So before that, we need to set the voltage, variable voltage, as 100 volt with the increment of 1%. We will set as. Now in the left side we have the gate terminal voltage, that initially we will set as the 5 volt supply. Now we will run this one. Run this circuit diagram. Let us see what will happen. So slowly we are varying the right side supply voltage, that is key A. When I make the sliding contact to be changed, the simultaneously voltage and current of the multimeters are changing. So it is observed that the ammeter is showing the negative current. See the top ammeter showing the negative current. So that means we need to change the polarity of the ammeter in the resistor R2. So that we need to change it, right? So let us change that. Now so after deleting that, once again I'm placing the multimeter here and do the connection. Before that, I'll make it as a flip horizontally so that the polarities are changed. Now we will connect. Now it is okay. Now we place the ammeter here. Now let us set the gate voltage as 5 volt, that is left side DC source. We will set as 5 volt. and we will vary the V2 voltage from 0 to 100 volt and measure the values. Measure the values of ammeter and voltmeter and take the readings and plot it in plot. Keep the readings in Excel. I am keeping the readings in the Excel. So those were from the sampled values. We are going to plot the graph of VI characteristics of SCR. So here randomly I am changing the voltage. So that time the voltage, voltmeter and ammeter values are changing. Now it is observed that at a voltage of 65, the voltmeter reading is reduced tremendously. 644. Like millivolt it has. Before that it is this value is very high. Now we will take the sampled values and plot taken the values in the Excel. That is the first column. We have 1.9 the volt and current value for the gate current of 9.3 milliampere. So we have taken the readings at a random interval. So let us zoom out this. Now we will plot. When I make the plot, we have the plot like this. So this is identically to the SCR characteristics. So to be visible, let us delete the horizontal lines and also the series one, that also we will delete. Now it is looking as the. Now come to the next one, the left side voltmeter, so left side voltage source, you change the value as 15 volt. Now I am changing the value as 15 volt, that is 15 volt I am changing. Now the same process you repeat by varying the voltage source V2 from 0 to maximum 70 volt. You randomly vary and measure the values of voltmeter and ammeter and tabulate them in the Excel sheet. So that we are randomly varying here. So when I make the sliding contact to be changed, the correspondingly the voltage and the current also changed. So those values are plotted in the Excel sheet, that is at the second tabular column, with the IG is equal to 14.3 milliampere. Now I will select those values. I will select those values and plot it here. Right, second column values, voltage and current values are selected, and we will plot insert and we will plot the graph. So this is the second graph we are getting. So this second graph is overlapped with the first graph. By just cut the graph, I am cut the graph and place it there in the first graph. So the first graph is selected and paste it. So those two graphs are merged. Now we need to do the third one the same manner. You do the third process, that is a gate voltage. V1 voltage is set as 30 volt, right? 30 volt. Now you do the same process as we have done in for the first two cases. That is the sliding contact values are changed. The values are values on the voltmeter and ammeter are tabulated here in the Excel sheet. If you see, the third value is taken for the gate current of 29.3 milliampere. So the values are tabulated, voltage and current values are tabulated, and we will plot the graph. So this is the third graph. So now this graph is also merged with the first two graphs. So let us cut the value. Let us cut this graph and place in the original graphs. So three values are plotted for different gate currents. We have three graphs. So from this graph we can observe that as the gate current is increased, the forward breakover voltages are getting decreased. So three graphs we have drawn. So in this way you can do the experiment for the forward characteristics of